Welcome student, hope you all are fine, happy and healthy. Now we are going to cover the last chapter of biology and it is the chapter number 18 of your test book and the name of the chapter is Pollution of Air and Water. In this chapter we are going to understand different aspects that causes air pollution and water pollution and their causes and effect also. So first of all, open your book, pen, pens, bring out all your necessary substances like pen, pencil and all, because while I am teaching I will give the questions and you need to write the questions and you have find the answer and I need to write all the answers in the fair copy. So let us start our learning. First of all, this is a very obviously interesting chapter and you are learning this chapter from very beginning, that is from class 5. So everyone have a good knowledge about this chapter, that is pollution. Just I am going to sweep all these things that has been given over here, because you know all these things very earlier from class 5. So the first question arises over here, define pollution. So here the definition of pollution has been given: whenever some other non-required substances mix into the natural substance, in that condition the natural substance become polluted. Means that definition is has been given by ERC. Pollution is known as term to us, it is related to contamination. From contamination means mixing, means something is just mixing in the natural air, water or in land, which make it dirty and unusable for us and for other organism as well. So this contamination of substances which make the air, water and land dirty is called pollution. Understood? So in three lines the definition has been given over here. Define pollution. What the cause of pollution? Now it is comes. Actually human being is a such a kind of organism on this world who always try to change the environment according to himself and make it more comfortable for himself. And for that, they always try to invent and research many more things. These inventions and research, moreover, make their life more suitable and comfortable, but they obviously cause different kinds of natural disturbance in the natural phenomenon, and obviously this cause the pollution. So here that cause of the pollution has been given. See, world is rapidly developing, which make our lives more easier to live. Obviously world is changing and our life is becoming more comfortable and easier, but at the same time we are destroying our nature, natural resources. Pollution is the mainly cause due to the human activity. Yeah, this is the thing. What is the cause of? Note down this question also. What is the cause of pollution? Hope you got the answer. Pollution is mainly caused by the human activity. And what are the different activities that cause the pollution? It is globalization and industrialization. There are two important terms that has been given over here: globalization and industrialization. Globalization is the different term in which different types of or different people introduce different kinds of business or industries in the different other countries. Means many countries people of many countries coming on in our country, and many people from our country goes to the other country for their business purpose and all. And in this way, they introduce different kinds of comfortable making business, or you can say industries and all. And these industries and business obviously causes pollution. And in another term, it is clearly given about industrialization. Obviously, the rapid industrialization in the world increase all the kind of pollution. That is air pollution, water pollution, as well as soil pollution, or you can say land pollution. So these are the two important terms that causes the mainly the pollution. Obviously, along with that, other causes also present over there that has not been mentioned. Obviously, it will be mentioned later on in each topic. So to demonize the effect of air, water pollution, some preventive measures has to be taken. So how can we prevent the air pollution, water pollution, or land pollution? By using some preventive measures. Understood? By using some preventive measures, we can demonize or we can reduce the effect of air pollution, water pollution, and land pollution. Understood? So here you are getting three questions. Now, very simple. The question arises over here. Define air pollution. Note down the another question. Define air pollution. So what is air pollution? Air pollution can be defined as the presence of toxic chemical or compound in air. Means air get mixed by certain toxic chemicals. Means some toxic chemicals mix into the air or some other compound also, which make the air unhealthy for both living things, or either with a human being or other living organisms. So it is called air pollution. So here you are getting the answer of air pollution. Air pollution can be defined as the presence of toxic chemicals or compounds in the air that pose the health risk. Health risk for both, either with a plant or animals. Understood? Since the time of industrial revolution, when the industrial revolution starts, it starts in 17th century. Air pollution has been increasing, and as the industries has been developing at the extreme fast, any substance in the air that cause harm to living beings and the environment is called air pollutant. Now question comes over here. Define air pollutant. Air pollutant, the spelling is given over here. So what is air pollutant? The substance which mix into the air, and make it dirty, or you can say and make it pollute, are called pollutant. Understood? So whatever the substance, when mixed into the air, it makes the air dirty and obviously not good for the organisms and causes health risk. So such a kind of substances are called air pollutant. Understood? It is given over here. Any substance in the air that cause harm to the living being and the environment is called air pollutant. So hope you got the answers of those questions that has been asked by me. Now we are going to cover the most important topic of today, that is, what are the causes of air pollution? There are several causes. What are the, note down this question, what are the causes of air pollution? So there are different causes that cause air pollution. Just we are going to cover each and every cause. So air pollution is caused due to human activities. You know these things. What kind of human activity is that cause air pollution? It is mining, construction, transportation, agriculture and smelting. So note down the question. What are the different human activity? What are the different human activity that cause air pollution? Note down. So what are the different human activity? It is mining. Mining means making the mines to extract out air, coal and petroleum. Construction of big buildings and all. Transportation means using vehicles. Agriculture, you know, different kinds of fertilizers and pesticides are used, obviously, and also the husk or the remnant of the agriculture residues are burned, which mix into the air and make the air pollute. And smelting is a process that is done in the industries, and it release a lots of sulfur and carbon like substances into the air. Understood? So these are the things. However, natural processes such as volcanic eruption, forest fire also pollute the air. So what are the natural cause of air pollution? Note down this question also. What are the natural cause of air pollution? Air pollution also caused due to volcanic eruption, forest fire and forest fire. Understood? Now, does the human activity are the major cause of air pollution and contribute the global pollution into the air every day? Now we are going to cover the topic in our what is the cause of air pollution. See, major contributor of air pollution is has been given over here. So first comes automobile emission. As you can see, the population is increasing, and due to rapid increasing of population, the number of vehicles are also increased on the road, and these vehicles obviously run on petrol, or you can say diesel, or you can say petroleum substances. So burning of these petroleum substances emit a lots of you can say air pollutant, and this air pollutant when mixed into the air make the air pollute. So rapid increasing of the population cause the using of automobile, and this automobile obviously emits a lots of poisonous gases which make the air pollute. It has been written over here. See, these emissions are the largest cause of air pollution. So one of the most important thing, largest cause. If somewhere it is asked, what is the reason, what is the largest cause of air pollution, at that time you must write automobile emission. Understood? The number of the vehicles on the road is increasing at an alarming rate, and this is due to increasing of population and urbanization. Urbanization means in making city, or the area where the number of cities has been increased. So the area around the city is called urban areas, and formation of cities is called urbanization. So due to rapid urbanization, the number of people gathered on that places, and they are using a lots of vehicles, and using the lots of vehicles emits a lots of air pollutant, cause air pollution. Hope you understood. Now automobile emissions are the ground level source of air pollution, means main reason of the air pollution, thus have the maximum impact of the general population. दिस व्हीकल रिलीज स्मोक विच कंटेन सेवरल पॉल्यूटेंट. सो हेयर क्वेश्चन ओवर अराइजेज ओवर हेयर, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ पॉल्यूटेंट मेनली कंटेन इन ऑटोमोबाइल एमिशन. नोट डाउन दिस क्वेश्चन, इट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ पॉल्यूटेंट प्रेजेंट इन ऑटोमोबाइल एमिशन. सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ पॉल्यूटेंट प्रेजेंट, इट इज मेनली, इट मेनली कंटेन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड. अंडरस्टूड. सो दीज आर द टू मेन पॉल्यूटेंट दैट आर रिलीज बाय ऑटोमोबाइल एज ऑटोमोबाइल इमिशन. नाउ लीड इज रिलीज समटाइम बिफोर. लीड इज यूटिलाइज विथ पेट्रोल and this lead get vaporized by the vehicles and mix into the air and make the air pollute. Now the vehicles has been advised to use unleaded, means the petrol in which no lead is there, okay, so that it can be controlled. So lead is released from the vehicle is in area where unleaded gasoline is not utilized. So it is also a main reason of air pollution. What? Vaporized lead. Understood. It causes to pollute the air. So now unleaded petrol is said to be used to reduce the pollution level. Now comes industrial emission. There are lots of gases, or you can say substances or pollutants are released by industries which mix into the air and make the air pollute. I hope you all know very well about these things. So let's study. Emission means coming out. Emission means releasing. Emission from industries are the second largest. Yeah. That was the first largest. Automobile was the first largest. It is the second largest cause of air pollution. Most of the industries such as thermal power plant, steel refineries are use coal is as the main source of fuel. And the combustion of coal release air pollutants such as sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide, smoke and dust. Harmful gases such as carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide cause acid rain and smog. So what have you got over here? In industries, lots of coal and petroleum like substances are utilized. Mainly the coal, burning of coal, release dioxides. What kind of dioxide? Carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide. These are the two main oxides that are released by burning of coal. And these dioxide, when mixed with the water, make the water acidic and cause acid rain. Along with that, some smoke and dust also released by burning of the coal, which make the air partially or translucent and cause smog. Means when smoke plus fog mixed together, it cause smog and it causes invisibility, that is mainly suffered by people in the cold countries, or you can say in the winter season. So the reason of smog is mainly the smoke. And from where do we get the smoke? Obviously this smoke is released by the industries by burning of coal and petroleum. Hope you're understanding. Now, suspended particulate matter. It is one of the most important thing. Remember, what do you mean by SPM or suspended particulate matter? Here, I didn't get the question, so write down the question. How? What are the main pollutant? What are the main pollutant? Main air pollutant. Main air pollutant released by industry. Industry. Note down. It is one of the most important question also. Remember. So, SPM, or you can say suspended particulate matter. These are the minute solid substances or solid particles that present in the air in form of smoke or dust that cause remain suspended for a long period of time. Means small drop in small air particles that remain in the air or dust particles, you can say, which mix into the air by wind or storm or anything or due to any reason. These particles does not suspend easily and make the air pollute. So this kind of particle is called SPM or suspended. These particles remain suspended at a certain level of the air, remain hang itself at the certain level of the air. So this kind of particle is called suspended particulate matter. So what is the definition given over here? There are the minute solids present in the air in form of smoke or dust that can remain suspended for a long period of time and are also remain main source of haze. Yeah, haze. Haze means not clear environment where the visibility become very less, that reduce visibility. So here you are getting the answer of question, what is called suspended particulate matter. Suspended particulate matter can be divided into two types: coarse particles and fine particles. So there are two kinds of particles. Coarse particles can be formed from the source such as road dust, spray or industrial activities, and fine particles are formed when the fuel is burnt, that is from automobiles and power plants. So how many kinds of SPMs are there? Note down. How many kinds of SPMs are there? SPMs are there. Note down this question. State the effect of SPM. State the effect of SPM on our health. SPM on our health. So, what is the effect of SPM? So, there are two kinds of SPM: coarse particles or fine particles. So what is the source of coarse particle? They are comes from the dust particles on the roads, spray and constructions. And fine particles are the main source. They are coming from the unburned particles of the automobiles and power plants. And what are the ill effects or effects? These particles go into the lungs and cause respiratory problems in the human being. Understood? So for today's class, you leave it for up till here. We will study in our next class from carbon monoxide. Okay, thank you for today. Okay, make the note and send it to me in WhatsApp. Bye bye.